One day, Daddy and Mommy Fish got quite feisty in the big blue sea. Days later, Mommy Fish became very fat and eventually pooped out some fish eggs. An extremely long time later, a fish was born. This fish was not BINBA Fish, but George, BINBA's older brother. By exactly 2 minutes, 42.3 seconds. Those exact minutes later, BINBA Fish hatched from the egg. A third and final fish came after BINBA, his younger sister, Nibba. BINBA and his siblings, George and Nibba, had a great time when they were younger. For example, they always played fish tag in the ocean next to a small island, untouched by man. One day, while playing tag, a peculiar group of people walked to the island. They began to build structures never seen by fish before. These structures included an underwater bunker, a modern house, a tiny house on a hill, and an ugly wooden cube. These homes evolved as time went on, but one day an alien-looking man walked up to the water. Now George was one hell of a fatty. When he saw food bobbing in the water, he had to dash over to it. But as it may seem, food floating in water that's connected to a string, which is also connected to a stick, is a trap to catch fish. BINBA Fish never forgot the sight of the alien man eating his only brother raw. BINBA and Nibba were forever sad. They wouldn't play tag anymore, only sit around in sadness. Later on that week, a big fish came up to them. This fish was a good 5 times the size of BINBA. They became friends with this chungus fish and found out his name was Deborah, despite the fact that he was a male fish. The three watched the pilgrims continue to build random farms of glass, as well as capturing animals such as cows and pigs. They even witnessed them turn against each other when one killed the other and made him lose all his experience levels. Soon after, the small house on the hill got set on fire. Later on, BINBA, Nibba, and Deborah noticed the people began capturing and breeding turtles. This struck danger into the hearts of the fish because they now knew that the people were moving on to capturing water animals. This didn't worry Nibba too much since she was studying to be an underwater electrical engineer. Nibba never got to fulfill her dreams, however. She got washed up on land after a huge gust of wind. Nibba attempted to flop her way back to the water, but the life left her eyes seconds before she reached. BINBA and Deborah waited for Nibba's return, but she never did. BINBA and Deborah grew older, both working 9-to-5 jobs at the local fish market, but they don't work on weekends because they're gangsters. On the 50th weekend of them working at the fish market, BINBA decided to bring Deborah to the place where he and his siblings used to play tag when they were younger. While both of them were mourning the losses of loved ones, they noticed a big fish swimming towards them. This fish was not like the others. This one was a human-sized and shaped fish, so much so that it was the same person that built the wooden cube. He had 2 buckets. He scooped up BINBA and Deborah. They were placed into small water tanks inside the cube's basement across the small brick room from each other. Deborah couldn't move anywhere as the space was barely large enough to fit him. Later on, the human fish and his friends went down to look at the fish. BINBA was happy that he and Deborah could now live peaceful lives without stressing about work and the deaths of his siblings. For once in years, BINBA was happy. BINBA's happiness did not last much longer than that, since the humans broke the tank Deborah was in and began beating him until he died. BINBA didn't see where the body of his friend went, but all he saw was the people walking out of the room looking very content with themselves. Later on that day, BINBA Fish noticed the fish man bring in a new fish to replace Deborah. This fish was a similar size to BINBA, but they never got to meet each other since they were both being held captive across from each other. BINBA watched as the man placed a black and red table in the center of the room, later on accompanied by a single bookshelf against the wall. Little did BINBA know the significance of this bookshelf on his life. BINBA had been reflecting on his life at the time of the events. He wanted to go back to the times when he and his siblings had no cares in the world. A time when everyone he loved surrounded him. A time of true happiness. All of a sudden, BINBA heard a loud cracking noise above his head. He soon realized that it was coming towards him. A hole popped open above the tank he was in. Then a lobster man fell into the tank. BINBA was not scared of the lobster because he seemed to be focused on something else. That something being the bookshelf. He jumped out into the room and grabbed the bookshelf. He ran back into BINBA's fish tank and placed a block to escape on the other half of the tank BINBA's in. The water disappeared. BINBA started flopping on the ground as fish out of water do. He figured that this would be the end of his life because there was no water near him to reach. He began to think about things such as, what is a fish without a river? What is a bird without a tree to nest in? What is an Endangered Species Act without any enforcement mechanism to ensure their habitat is protective? It is nothing, and that nothing is what BINBA became. Being a fish out of water is tough, but that's how you evolve. BINBA knew this. He knew it was over. He accepted what he knew was going to happen. He began to let go. As he let go, his world got dark, as if he were going to sleep for a final moment. But this time, he was not waking up. This was the end of BINBA's fish and all that he knew of forever. The end.
What are we doing?
I gotta get some spins.
Swinging your hand.
You hear it off of one hand now.
This. Wait, I'm trying.
No! I'm gone, dude.
I still see your armor in my room. Can't take back the diamonds I gave you. It's to the point where I steal it, I grieve you. And I cannot help you to survive Minecraft. Oh, see a mob, we just run TNT just for fun. Listen to my list instead of you, Steve. You found an ocelot, but I found three doggies. I won't let you raid from me. I still see your armor in my room.
Can't
take
option.
Back the diamonds I gave you. It's to the point where I steal it and I grieve you. And I cannot help you to survive Minecraft. Oh, see a mob, we just run TNT just for fun. Listen to Alex instead of you, Steve. You found an ocelot, but I found three doggies. I won't let you raid from me.
You left me falling and landing inside lava. I know that you want me dead. I take these potions to make me heal up my Steve. I know it's all in my chest. I have these Minecraft dreams where I can't move my pick, thinking of you in my cave. You were my Minecrafter, thoughts of a diamond house. Now I'm just better off dead. I'll mine it over again. I lost my oars in the end. I watched oars burn in the lava. I should've listened to my Steves. Leave the moors in the chest, but I wanted to mine more. You were a man out of iron, oars fake. I was tangled up in your griefing ways. Who knew Hero Brian had the prettiest face? You gave me some oars that were full of mistakes. I gave you my pick, and you made my pick break. You made my pick break. You made my pick ache. You made my pick break. You made my pick ache. You made my pick break. You made my pick ache. You made my pick break again.
This was fun.
I still see your armor in my room. Can't take back the diamonds I gave you. It's to the point where I steal it and I grieve you. And I cannot help you to survive Minecraft. Oh, see a mob, we just run TNT just for fun. Listen to Alex instead of you, Steve. You found an ocelot, but I found three doggies. I won't let you raid from me. I still see your armor in my room. Can't take back the diamonds I gave you. It's to the point where I steal it and I grieve you. And I cannot help you to survive Minecraft. Oh, see a mob, we just run TNT just for fun. Listen to Alex instead of Steve. You found an ocelot, but I found three doggies. I won't let you raid from me.
Oh gosh, no, wait, I need to get my hand back.
Like the moors in the chest, but I wanted my more. You were made out of iron or fake. I was tangled up in your grieving ways. Who knew Hero Brian had the prettiest face?